the artwork that she is most recognized for is a very, very open kind of dripped paint style that she refers to as being a form of impressionism. And it certainly has similarities to impressionism in terms of it's got a very, very active surface, animated and broken so that the surface itself is incredibly interesting. And of course she uses very bright pastelish colors, and that also kind of resonates with the impressionistic heritage.
They didn't know what to call me at first when I came out with my art so loose and so different for Native Americans. And finally people decided I am an impressionist. But I think because at first when I started, I'd copy photos and what I seen, but now I just do what comes from me. And it's loose and it's fantasy. When my grandparents raised me, we had a wood stove. Now I'm telling my age, but we had a wood stove, and I remember doing a lot of, we had coloring books, and I used to love to melt the crayons on that stove and watch them run down. You know, it was so neat to me to see how the colors would all come together.
While struggling to find her own identity in the art world, Joanne discovered by accident something that changed her life and artwork forever.
And I tried a lot of different styles and different, but I was mainly trying to find out who I was. I was ready to quit when I was throwing my paint on the canvas, and I enjoyed it. I mean, I loved what I was seeing happen. I saw it so different and so neat, you know, to watch these colors, just like on a wood stove I saw you when I was small, watch them run together. And then my husband took a few of those paintings into his show, and I said, don't show those, you know, those are the ones I enjoy. And we had some buyers for them immediately. So I said, bring all the rest at home.
When you see a Joanne Bird, there's little or no doubt that that's what you're looking at. So that kind of signature style makes her stand out. A lot of people bounce around, try different things, sometimes radically different sorts of things. And Joanne's work has not done that. I mean, it's not that she doesn't push herself, and it's not that she doesn't try other things, but there's a kind of consistency in her work that is really recognizable.
It's not only Joanne's unique style that separates her from other artists.
Her long-standing, serious professional commitment to her work. Now, she became a professional artist in the late 60s, early 70s, and has consistently worked at that as a career over the past 30-some years. That in itself is, I think, a landmark or a model for other artists, both native and non-native in South Dakota, that a person can make a career out of an artist being an artist as your exclusive occupation. So I think that it makes her stand out.
I never lived in the olden days, so all I could do is fantasize about it, but I do it in my own way. I guess that's the difference. I do different colors and brightness are dull, but I just do everything myself, and I do what I feel. And I don't get stuck into one theme or one color or one. I keep trying to myself make myself grow. I don't get any inspiration. It's just what I'm painting, and it's what I feel and what. I paint so different because I can throw a color on there, and then I throw another color, then I kind of can see what I'm going to do, then I start going for whatever I'm going to paint. Sometimes I don't know when they're finished. I stand back and I go back and forth a while. Then when I sign my name, I know it's done. Each one I hope is better than the last.
taken as a whole, the subject matter is fairly traditional, but with a kind of contemporary bent to it. And I think part of what people enjoy about her work is that combination of subject matter, which has been around in the Native American fine arts movement for many, many, many years, and the application of the paint in a contemporary update of Impressionism.
Joanne attributes the success of her artwork to the long-standing traditions of the indigenous people.
The culture is still alive, and we as people do keep it alive because we still have all the celebrations. The language is still there, and they're keeping the traditions alive, and I think everybody, in a way, should know who, what their identity is. When you find out who you are and can do your own thing and not copy people, and really love what you do, it'll take care of them.